I've got to play the Castlevania Lord of Shadow, Lords of Shadow. I've played, I think, 1 or 2 hours, and so this is my little impression video. Okay, first up is the story. The story is like light and dark, a god and a devil, and kind of just the darkness trying to eliminate all of mankind and pretty much doing the good thing. And Gabriel Belmont is trying to, of course, you know, defeat the evil that roams the lands. And that is what I know of the story of right now. There's also something with his wife that died like 2 days ago, whatever. You know, it's just a common story, light and dark, the gods and the devils, whatever. But it's an interesting story because the voice acting is really, really good. There's that one guy from Star Trek, like Jean-Luc Picard. I have no idea how what his name is in real life, but I just call him Captain Picard. And his voice is just amazing, really cool, you know, voice acting. Also, the soundtrack in this game, you all know me, I totally love epic soundtracks like, you know, God of War and Dante's Inferno. And this is definitely, definitely on par with it. It is an awesome, awesome soundtrack. It has this gothic, fantasy, epic music, really, really cool. And I saw like a video review on YouTube of a guy, and he said that, you know, that the graphics were, you know, it gets really close to games as Killzone 2 and Uncharted 2. And I was like, no way, a multi-platform can never do that. But damn, this game looks amazing. This game really, really looks amazing. And like, especially like the forest, you know, there are like a lot of scenes where you're in like a huge forest. I won't say it looks better than the Uncharted 2 forest, but it's definitely up there. I mean, the graphics are amazing. It's definitely the best looking multi-platform game I have ever played. On the PS3, of course. Well, that is, of course. I'm sorry. Okay, but whatever. So the graphics are really good. The sound is amazing. The gameplay, yes, it feels like God of War. Just if you press square, you know, you do like slashing, and it looks like a God of War combo, and it feels like a God of War combo, but it's not God of War. And I'm not going to say it's a clone or whatever, because Castlevania has its own distinctive look and how it kind of plays. And to be honest, if they made like a 2D version and let people pay $60 for it, no one's gonna buy that. That is now on the Xbox network and whatever. But this is a really, really, really good action hack and slash. I mean, this year is really good for action hack and slash games. Like we had got Dance Inferno, we got God of War, and like Enslaved. So really, really cool. Yeah, Castlevania, Lords of Shadow. I mean, I'm really, really enjoying it. Hopefully, the guys that picked it up are also enjoying it. And if you haven't gotten the game yet, I mean, if you have the money, definitely, definitely buy this game. If you want to wait, then just wait. I also totally love the art design. It is really like Castlevania. It really is Japanese, even though I think it's not developed by a Japanese developer, because it's called Mercury Steam. Maybe it's like United States, I don't know. But it definitely has this Castlevania Japanese style to it. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Good sound, great graphics, good voice acting, really fast paced and really good. Even though it's a little bit like God of War, combat system, definitely a lot of different enemies, a lot of different environments. It's not like you're running 20 minutes in like snow and you're fighting 20 minutes the same enemies over and over again. Different enemies, different environments, really cool. And a lot of stuff to unlock, a lot of artwork, a lot of combos to buy, and a lot more. So that is my impression of Castlevania Lords of Shadow. Now I'm going to play it again. And hopefully in a couple of weeks or a couple of months, I don't know, the review will be online. So see you later.